Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can check whether the input number is Armstrong or not, right? So before starting, if you go to detail of this video, so you will find various links of playlists. Those are related to various programs. So you can watch them if you want to learn more programming. So now starting, so first, I'm going to explain what Armstrong is. Then I will be implementing a program that is related to C so that you can learn how we can check whether the input number is Armstrong or not. So if we take a number as input, let's say 153, and we perform this operation. So we divide individual digits, then we take Q of each individual digit and we add all those values. And if their addition comes equal to the original number, then that number is known as Armstrong number. So 1 cube is 1 plus 5 cube is 125 plus 3 cube is 27. Now add all these values. So 126, then 7133, and we add 20, then it will be 153. So if you add all these three numbers, 1, 125, and 27, so output will be 153, right? So it means 153 is Armstrong number, right? Now, we have two methods to check whether the number is Armstrong or not. So if number is 1234, and if we are taking this, so here notice it carefully, here number is having four digits, but still we are having power as 3, right? So this is first method of calculating Armstrong. This is first method of calculating Armstrong. It means we are applying power as 3 irrespective of the number of digits those are available in the number. Now, next example will be, if number is 1234, so we need to apply this. If number is having 4 digits, so power will be 4. If number is, let's say, 12, so power will be 2, and so on. And after calculating these, if number is equal to original number, then it will become Armstrong number. So first I am going to explain this logic, like every time power will be 3, right? We need to calculate the Q, and after implementation of this, I will convert that program into this so that first we will identify number of digits in the given number and then we will take that count as a power of individual digits, right? So first I am going to implement this. So starting with main, I am declaring some variables. So first is n, then I am taking variable a, then I am taking variable s and variable t as a temporary, right? Now printf will display a message, enter a number, then scanf will read that number into variable n. Right? Now after reading that number, now I am going to apply a while loop where I will be dividing these individual values and then I am calculating their Q. So while n greater than 0, while n greater than 0, then inside this loop I am applying this a equals to n modulus 10. So I am taking modulus of this n by 10. So remainder will be available into a. So a will be having a particular digit. So now I have to calculate its Q. So I am writing this. So I am adding cube of a with s, and the result, final result of this expression will again assign into s. And then n equals to n by 10, right? Now after completion of this loop, I will apply if condition. So my final addition will be available into s. So I'm going to compare this s with original value so that I can identify whether the solution is having number s prime, number s Armstrong or not, right? So first I'm going to explain this logic and then I will apply if condition. So for example, number is 153. Number is 153. So starting from here, so if we check this condition, it is true. We are coming here. So n modulus 10. So whenever we divide any number by 10, so remainder will be last digit. So A will be having 3 as result here. Then initially s is 0. So multiply A 3 times. So 3 into 3 into 3. It is 27. And that will be added into s and stored into s. So new value of s will become 27. Now divide n by 10. So n is right now 153. So if we divide the number by 10, so its last digit will be removed automatically and remaining will be stored inside the variable again if we write n equals to n by 10. So here you can see n is 153. If we divide it by 10, so result will be 15.3. So we are assigning 15 into n because data type is int here. Now repeat this again. So here you can see right now n is 15. So condition is true. 15 modulus 10. So A will be having 5 as a remainder. Now 5 into 5 into 5. So if we multiply 5 3 times, so it will be 125. And we have to add 125 with S. So S is 27. So if we add 27 and 125, so it will be 152. Then again divide n by 10. So n is 15. So it will be having n. So 15 by 10 is 1.5. So a new value of n will be 1. Now again check this condition. So 1 is greater than 0. Take the modulus. So modulus will be 1. Then 1 into 1 into 1 will be 1. 1 will be added to s. So s is 152. Now it will be 153. Then again divide n by 10. So right now n is 1. So if we divide 1 by 10, so the result will be 0 point something. So now n is 0. Now check this condition. It is false. So it means your loop is completed and the sum s variable is containing this value 153. So here after completion of this loop, you can apply if condition, where you can write n double equals to n, sorry, n double equals to s. So s is having sum of cubes and n, n is the variable which received the actual number from the user. So we are going to compare them, right? But before going forward, after this completion, after completion of this loop, if you check the value of n, what it is? 0. So now if you compare n and s, so every time n will become 0 after completion of this loop. So this if condition will become false always, right? So now to overcome with this problem, I have declared one variable as t. So before starting this loop, here you need to write this. Here you need to write this t equals to n. So what we are doing, we are assigning value of n temporarily into t variable, and that is before starting of this while loop. So after completion of this while, n will become 0, but original value of n is copied into t. So t will be having the original value that is provided by the user. So in place of n, we can write t here. So whenever you want to maintain a copy of a particular variable, so assign that value into another variable so that if actual variable is not having actual value after certain process, so the value will be available in the other variable who is having the copy. So here we are using the copy of n in comparison. So copy of n is available in t. S is having sum of cubes. So if both are equal, then we can print number is Armstrong. Else we can print number is not Armstrong, and then you can use the main function. So this way I took example of 153. If I take example of 1234, then also here you can see its Q will be calculated, because A is multiplied 3 times whatever number of digits are available in the number. So it will be always calculating cubes of a particular digit. So I hope you understood this method. Like, if we have any number, so we will be separating its individual digits and we are calculating its cubes. Then we are adding together all the result and then comparing whether it is Armstrong or not. Now I am going to convert this program for this logic. So here first we need to count how many digits are available in the number, and then that digit will be used as a power of a particular digit. So before starting this loop, I need to add one more loop here. So I'm going to use that. So here you can see this loop is written here. So now before starting this loop, we need to write one more loop so that we can count number of digits those are available in the number. So here I am implementing while n greater than 0. So I am using one more variable as c. So here it will calculate c++ so that we can count the number when n equals to n by 10, right? So now see the order. First printf, then scanf. Then you need to write this. The value of n will be available temporarily into t. So this time both are having same value. After this, you need to write this. So this loop will calculate how many digits are available in the number. And again, after completion of this loop, n will become 0, because we are dividing n by 10 and assigning it into n. So here you can write this. N equals to t. So t is having copy of n, so again it is assigning back it to n. So again n is having the original value, and then you can start this loop. And here instead of this, you need to write a predefined function, that is POW a comma c. So POW is defined in math.h. so above main you need to include a header file, that is math.h. So you can use its predefined function POW, then A is the base and C will be the power. So this loop will identify number of digits, and after calculating number of digits, that value will be available into C, and that C will be treated as power here, and rest of the process will be C. So this way this logic will be implemented. So I hope you understood how we can check whether the input number is Armstrong or not. So I explained you two different methods. You can implement any one that is suitable to your requirement. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and there you will see more than 1000 videos related to computer programming. So do watch them. Thank you for watching this video.